from the men, but they all thought he was huge, so they didn't care. From all of the letters that were sent that day, everyone seemed to be in good hopes and thought that the journey would turn out well. In July of 1845, a whaling ship passed the Terror in the Erebus at the Baffin Bay as the whaling ship was heading back to England and the expedition was working its way closer to the Canadian Arctic. The sighting of the whaling ship is the last time that any of the crew were ever seen alive. At least officially, but we'll get there. Now, before I get into theories and talking about what happened with the expedition, specifically the discoveries that were made, let's talk about what led up to those discoveries. See this?
I had compared five universities and five programs, and Walden stood out for me. My degree aligned with the work that I was doing.
Voyage in particular was supposed to take about a year and a half. So when 1847 rolled around and there was no word from any ships that had seen him or any letters conveyed back home, people started to worry. And one of those people was Lady Franklin herself. Whenever she brought her concerns to the Admiralty, they said that they were unfounded. So Franklin, in an attempt to find out of her husband's whereabouts, began to amass people and committees in order to get the state to do something. To which her friend Charles Dickens began writing in the paper, urging the public to say something about the missing Franklin expedition. Eventually, the government did and sent two sea expeditions and one land expedition across northern Canada to look for any sign of the crew. Furthermore, the state put out a £20,000 reward for anyone who could find the crew, which by today's money is about $2 million. And thanks in no small part to Lady Franklin's urging, it became a matter of public interest of what became of the expedition itself. A song even became popular at the time, known as Lady Franklin's Lament. Eventually, the search party found some sign of the expedition when in 1850 on Beachy Island, they found several tin cans, what looked to be the remnant of a camp, as well as three graves buried in the ice. The names on the headstones were that of three members of the expedition, spaced out over the course of the month. It wasn't uncommon for people to get out in the middle of the cold and die of or tuberculosis, so this didn't prove that the entire crew had met the tragic end, and as a matter of fact, it shows that they were in enough state that they could still bury their dead. However, the dates on the tombstone indicated that they were buried in 1845, meaning that this had to occur in the first several months of the expedition. Furthermore, in 1851, an iceberg began to be
just killed somebody. The fuck?
It turned out later that these were actually two abandoned whaling ships, but stories of seeing two giant ships frozen in ice didn't well in the ocean.
M4, and I also got you two AUG mags, Nans. Huh. I was not expecting that.